हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज विजया जनार्दन उशीर वर्किंग एज अ असिस्टंट प्रोफेसर इन मराठा विद्या प्रसारक समाज जीएमडी कॉलेज सिन्नर नासिक. सो दिस इज योर फर्स्ट लेक्चर फॉर द एमएससी फर्स्ट एंड इन दैट एमएससी फर्स्ट कोर्स आई विल टीच यू द फिजिकल केमिस्ट्री कोर्स. एंड इन द फिजिकल केमिस्ट्री कोर्स व्हाट इज द सिलेबस ऑफ दैट फिजिकल केमिस्ट्री कोर्स फॉर द फर्स्ट ईयर एंड फर्स्ट टर्म. So, in this video lecture, we will study the introduction to the syllabus of MSc First Physical Chemistry course. So, in that first section of the physical chemistry course is the fundamentals of physical chemistry. Means the name is fundamentals of physical chemistry. In that, we will study the first chapter, that is thermodynamics. At TYBSC level, you may have studied TY. Not only TY, at also FY, SY, TY, at any level you have studied the thermodynamics. But in MSc level, we will study the details about the thermodynamics. So, in the thermodynamics, what points we will cover? So, what is the state function, path function, exact differential, inexact differential, internal energy and enthalpy. Also, the temperature dependence of internal energy and enthalpy. Also, the reversible and irreversible adiabatic expansion, the entropy of irreversible changes, the Helmholtz and Gibbs function, the entropy change, entropy and entropy change in the ideal gas with temperature and pressure, Clausius inequality, this also you may have studied at the TYBSC level, chemical potential of substance in a mixture. And this chapter has a weightage of about 5 lectures. So this was the first chapter, that is the thermodynamics. Second chapter is the change of state. So in the change of state, we will study what are the partial molar quantities, what are the different methods for the determination of these partial molar quantities. So partial molar quantities, that is partial molar volume, these quantities, and what is the method for determination of these quantities, what is the ideal solution, what is the Raoult's law, Henry's law, and thermodynamics of Gibbs function of mixing. Means thermodynamics of Gibbs function of mixing, if we mix two reactants, so what is the Gibbs function of mixing, that thermodynamics also we will study in the second chapter. And what are the colligative properties? So you may have studied the colligative properties. So in this chapter, that is change of state, we will in detail study the colligative properties. So which are that colligative properties? That is elevation in boiling point, depression in freezing point, and osmosis. So this chapter is about of 3 lecture weightage. So third chapter is the quantum chemistry, and which is one of the most important chapter that you will study in this section first. At TYBSC level, you may have studied the basics of quantum mechanics, but at MSc level, you will study some details about the quantum mechanics. So in that, we will study the applications of quantum chemistry. So which are the different applications? Why we study the quantum chemistry? So what are the black body radiations? This also you have studied in TYBSC, black body radiation, photoelectric effect, de Broglie's hypothesis, uncertainty principle, and its experimental evidence. Means all these factors, this black body radiations, photoelectric effect, and de Broglie's hypothesis and uncertainty principle and their experimental evidence. Also, the one of the most important point that we will study in quantum chemistry is that is the Schrodinger wave equation and particle in 1D box. So then also the normalization and orthogonality, these terms may be new for you, but we will study what these all the things mean. So in detail we will study in the quantum chemistry. So normalization, orthogonality of wave function, particle in 3-dimensional box, means we will study particle in 1D box also and particle in 3-dimensional box also, hydrogen atom, and no derivation for this, means only the hydrogen atom we will study in very not detailed form. So what are the different operators, what is the algebra of operators, means what are the operators, that is the operators are the different functions, and what is that algebra of that operators, what is commutative property, linear operator, commutator operator, and operator del and del square, that is the operator del and del square we will also study in the quantum chemistry chapter. And in this chapter, that is quantum chemistry, in the one of the biggest chapter of your section first, that is fundamentals of physical chemistry, and it has about 8 lectures to complete. So the last chapter, that is fourth chapter, that is a chemical bonding. So in the chemical bonding, what the different points we will cover, that is the valence bond theory. So this theory we have also studied in TYBSC level. So what is the valence bond theory, what are the hybrid orbitals, what is the geometry and hybridization of molecular orbital, then theory of for the di and triatomic molecules, means this valence bond theory we will study for di and triatomic molecule, what is the linear variation method, and the approximations lying under the Huckel's theory, means which are the different approximations lying in the Huckel's theory. In the organic chemistry, you may have studied the Huckel's theory for the aromatic system. So in the physical chemistry also we will study the Huckel's theory and approximations lying under the Huckel's theory, and their application to simple pi systems, means Huckel's, we know that the Huckel's theory, Huckel's molecular orbital theory, is applicable to systems containing pi electrons. So what is the application of this Huckel's theory to the simple pi system, that we will also study in the fourth chapter, that is a chemical bonding, and it will take a weightage about the 7 lectures. So this was the 4 chapters for the section first. First was the thermodynamics, second was the change of state, third was the quantum chemistry, and last was the chemical bonding. Then this was the first section was all about the thermodynamics, and in the second section we will study the chemical kinetics and reaction dynamics. So you have studied the chemical kinetics, so you know that what is the chemical kinetics. In the section second, we will study in detail the chemical kinetics and reaction dynamics. In that, first chapter is the recapitulation. First chapter is called as the rate laws. So we will study in that first, that is the recapitulation of basic concepts of chemical kinetics, temperature dependent reaction rates, so reaction moving towards equilibrium, consecutive reaction, parallel reaction, pre-equilibria, and unimolecular reaction. Means these may terms, this consecutive reaction, parallel reaction, pre-equilibria, unimolecular reaction, these are all new terms that we will study in the rate law chapter, that is first chapter in detail, and which takes a weightage about 6 lecture. So in the second chapter we will study the kinetics of complex reactions. So in that we will study the fast reactions, flash photolysis, flow techniques, stop flow technique. In that flow techniques we will study the stop flow technique, relaxation methods, steady state approximation, chain reaction, free radical polymerization, reaction between H2 and Br2 molecule, and also the explosive reaction, and this will take about the weightage of 3 lectures. Third chapter, that is the molecular reaction dynamics. So in that we will study the collision theory of bimolecular gas phase reactions. You may have studied the collision theory, so at the SYBSC or TYBSC level, in that, in this MSc first, we will study in detail the collision theory of bimolecular gas phase reactions. So also the diffusion control and activation control reactions in solutions. Also the activated complex theory of the reaction rates and Eyring's equation. And this will take a weightage about the 5 lectures. And fourth chapter is the enzyme catalysis. This is also one of the important chapter. In that we will study the Michaelis-Menten mechanism, the effect of pH, temperature on the reaction rate, the limiting rate, Lineweaver-Burk plot and ED plot. These are the two plots, Lineweaver-Burk and ED plots, that indicates the enzyme inhibition, means inhibit the activity of enzyme, that we will study in this chapter. Also the competitive, non-competitive inhibition, means the inhibition of enzyme, that is competitive inhibition, and non-competitive inhibition, that also we will study in the fourth chapter, that is enzyme catalysis. And this takes about the weightage of 4 lectures. And the last chapter and most important chapter of the section 2nd, that is molecular thermodynamics. So this may be all, these all terms may be new for you, but we will study in detail when we will study that particular chapter. So last chapter is the 5th chapter, that is molecular thermodynamics. So in that study, in that chapter, we will study the molecular energy levels, the Boltzmann distribution law, partition functions and ensembles, the translational, rotational, vibrational partition functions of diatomic molecules. Means you know that the different types of energy, that is translational, rotational and vibrational. We will study the translational, rotational and vibrational partition functions of diatomic molecules, obtaining the energy, heat capacity, entropy, free energy, equilibrium, also the equilibrium constant from the partition functions, equipartition of energy, Maxwell, Boltzmann and Fermi, Dirac and Bose-Einstein statics. This is the one of the important topic of this chapter, that is the Fermi, Dirac and Bose-Einstein Einstein statistics. And this chapter will take a weightage about the 6th lecture. So this was all about the syllabus of section 1st physical chemistry, which consists of four chapter, and the section 2nd of the physical chemistry, that is chemical kinetics. In that we will study the 5 chapters, and section 2nd is all about the equations and derivations, and in the section 1st we will study some theoretical part. So this was the syllabus for the your physical chemistry course. So what are the different references you have to study for the this MSc First physical chemistry course? So in the our departmental library and also the our college library, you may have found the books, that is Physical Chemistry by P.W. Atkins and D. Pauli, that is 8th edition 2010. Means these are the some references you have to study for that physical chemistry course. Physical Chemistry by T. Angel and Red, this is also one of the good book, and Pearson's Education 2006. Third is the Physical Chemistry and Molecular Approach by McQuarrie and Simon by University of Science 2000. Then also we have to you will study the Physical Chemistry for Biological Sciences by Raymond Chench. Also the you may study this book also, the Physical Chemistry by Maron and Pruton. Also the Physical Chemistry for G.M. Barrow and Tata McGraw-Hill. This is one of the best book. And for the quantum chemistry, the best book is the Levine, which is the 5th edition. And these all the books, this and in all these books, that Atkin and Levine for the quantum chemistry and the physical chemistry G.M. Barrow, these are the important books. So all these books you may find in our college library also, and also department of library. So you have to study your physical chemistry course, that is for section 1st also and section 2nd also, you must have to study these reference books, and then only you will understand the concepts of this. So this was all about the syllabus of physical chemistry and what are the different references you will choose for the studying the physical chemistry course, because this is not like that up to the TYBSC that you will take any publications and you will study. So at the MSc level, you must have to know what are the different references, how to use the references, and how to study from the references. So these references are the most important for the MSc first. So after the graduation level, at post graduation, you must have to study from the references only, and not only the small books or notes. So thank you. In the next lecture, we will start our first section, that is the first section, chemical fundamentals of physical chemistry course, and in that we will study the first chapter, that is our thermodynamics, and the basics of thermodynamics you have studied up to the BSc level, and in the detail we will study that chapter, that is thermodynamics. So thank you.